High ground. That is Cowton Hill. On Cowton Hill we have Nelson Monument. On top of Nelson Monument we have a black ball. That is the time ball. The time ball was put into place in 1852. And what normally happens is, shortly before 1 o'clock, the time ball is raised to the top of the mighty mast and then dropped precisely at 1 o'clock at the same time as the gunfire. Now the problem with the time ball was that when the mist coming off the seas, the ship's captains complained that they couldn't see the time ball dropping, so they couldn't set their chronometers. Hence the reason why the audible signal was brought in. Before the time ball was put into place, the ship's captains, who had to leave the vessels, climb up to the top of the hill and set their chronometers with the Astronomer Royal on Cowton Hill. Okay, back to the audible signal. Back in 1861, it was fired by an 18-pounder smoothbore muzzle-loading cannon. It was fired from a half-moon battery, which is at that end of the castle. However, during the early 1970s, during one of the tattoo performances, there was an explosion. Nothing to do with the gunfire. However, this explosion caused damage to the half-moon battery, and ever since then, the gun has fired from down here at Mills Mount. The gun currently in use is an L118-105mm light gun. It has a maximum range of 17,200 metres. The gun itself weighs at just under 2 tonnes and can be on a Sunday helicopter and carried around the battlefield in that manner. The L118-105mm light gun is still in service throughout the world with the British Army today. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, once you fire the gun, please feel free to ask me any questions. And also, so good, you can have a photograph taken with me. Yeah. And no extra charge.
Quite an actor. How did you get to the O-fire?
So, here we are at the top of Scott Monument. It's very tall, 200 feet plus 6 inches. So, we're not right at the top. We have, however, just climbed several hundred steps.
Don't look up.
Why not? Why not? Why not don't look up? That's a long way up to the top, still. Yeah, but there's a fantastic view from up here. You can see Edinburgh Castle there. Just a quick update, we have just climbed a rather tall hill up there. I call it a mountain, but the Scots call it a hill. That would be Arthur's Seat, which is part of Holyrood Park. It has two peaks, one of which is Arthur's Seat, the other one, I can't remember what it's called. Anyway. We've had a fantastic stay in Edinburgh. We're about to head on up to North Queen's Ferry. Food was good. It was a bit expensive, but you expect that in a big city like that. No real complaints, other than that the hostel was too hot, but there's not a lot you can do about that. Mike, anything to add?
Hi.
Anything to add?
Oh, I was leaning over the edge of cliffs, and supposedly I'm scared of heights.
Well, that's up
climbed
to you.
Climbed up to tall mountains, tall towers yesterday, looked down over them, and I am supposedly still scared of heights.
Well, yes. Well, always do things that are out of your comfort zone.
And I nearly fell down a mountain, so Aye.
Well, that was up to you. He tried to take the, shall we say, more challenging but shorter route down the side of the mountain. I just meandered down the paths, and guess what? I got back to the car first. Yeah, anyway.
10 seconds. 10 seconds in it.
No, there wasn't. There was about 2 minutes in it. Anyway, yeah, it seems a popular place for tourists and runners and walkers and what have you. I think I might actually have found myself a new hobby. It was a challenge getting to the top. I felt like I might have lost some weight. And I did enjoy the view. Mike is now dancing a jig out of shot. Deliberately out of shot. I wouldn't want you to see it. Anyway, I will see you onward.
It was easy. It was a small hill. Tiny weeny hill. I ran up some of it.
Look it up. Look it up. You'll see.
And whatever comes our way, yeah, darling, go make it happen. Take the world in a loving embrace. Fire all of your guns and pumps and explode into space. I like smoking lightning, heavy metal thunder, racing with the wind. Yeah!